Hi, how's it going, guys?
Good. I'm Miss Penny, and these are the KidVision Kids, and we're here today to find out what happens on the Miami Science Barge.
Well, I'm Chad. I'm one of the scientists on the Miami Science Barge, so why don't we go ahead and go check it out?
Yes!
All right, let's go.
Let's go.
Well, welcome to the Miami Science Barge, guys. So this is a floating environmental education center, and we're using solar energy in order to grow food and in order to keep our fish alive out here. Do you guys know where solar energy comes from?
From the sun.
From the sun, good job.
Good.
So we use panels like this in order to capture some of that energy and make electricity, so that we can do different experiments out here and we can grow food sustainably. We have 48 solar panels on board this barge. And that's about as many solar panels as you would need in order to power the all the electricity in a big house.
That's pretty great, all from the sun.
This is one of the solar panels. So what we do is we put this on the roofs of our houses, and we put them on the storage containers that we use as offices here on the Miami Science Barge.
That feels kind of cold.
That's because it's not a very sunny day today, but I bet it collects energy because there is some sun in the sky, right?
Oh, yeah, there's plenty of energy coming from the sun so that we can keep powering the barge all day, even with this many clouds.
Hi, Miss Penny.
Hi.
Hi, KidVision Kids. My name's Alyssa, and I also work on the Miami Science Barge. So today, we are gonna learn about plankton. Have you guys heard of plankton before?
No.
No? Plankton mean animals that float and drift in the ocean. So they can be big animals, like jellyfish, or really small animals, which is what we're gonna look at in the microscope today. But they're really important because they make up the bottom of the food chain. These plankton feed small fish, crustaceans, animals like that. And then larger animals will eat the small animals. And that goes all the way up the food chain until we get to our top predators. So now we're gonna take a water sample from Biscayne Bay and look at it under the microscope. So let's go put on life jackets.
Yay!
Alright guys, well here on the Miami Science Barge, we like to grow a lot of our own food. And one way that we grow these plants is through a process called hydroponics. Now, can some of you guys tell me what plants need in order to grow? Yes, Taylor.
They need food.
Okay, what about you, Grace?
Water.
Water. Sean, do you know what else plants need to grow?
Sun.
Very good. So the way that we're growing these plants is we're not using any dirt or soil. We're just using water. So water comes down these trays, and you see there's water coming out of this tube right here?
Yeah.
So when we're growing things with hydroponic methods, we're using less water actually, because we recycle that water. We're reusing that water over and over again. Well, what we're gonna do now is we're gonna harvest some of the lettuce that we've grown here. It's way too old, and it's time for us to go ahead and plant some new lettuce. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna grab the base of them. Can you all grab one of the heads of lettuce?
Is this the base of them?
Yes, ma'am. How about on three, we pull it out of the tray. Ready?
Okay.
One, two, three.
Yeah. Whoa, look at those roots.
Yeah, so you guys see the bottom?
Wow, look at the roots.
Those are the plant roots.
Right, there's no dirt, there's no soil. What is it grown in?
Yeah, it's just growing in water and nutrients, and then the sun allows them to grow. I think we should put some new plants in, right?
I think that's a good idea.
So we can grow more so we can have more lettuce for the salad.
Exactly, Taylor, great idea. 5 weeks, we'll have big heads of spinach that we can harvest. So, what's in this tank right here?
Fish,
yeah. So we have some tilapia fish in here. You guys ever seen tilapia before?
No.
So what we're doing with these tilapias, we're farming them, right? And that's called aquaculture. But not only are we farming these fish, but we're also using their waste, also known as the fish poop that the tilapia produce, in order to feed those plants.
Remember, Taylor, when you said that the plants needed food?
Yes.
This is the food that they eat. They eat the fish poop, and it goes through, like, the water. We're reusing the water, and it goes, you see our plants over there?
Yeah.
So when we're growing our plants with fish, in combination with fish, it's called aquaponics, okay? And so the fish poop is acting as plant food, and the plants are helping keep the water clean for the fish. So they're helping each other out.
The Miami Science Barge farms another type of fish too, called cobia. Let's feed them.
Okay guys, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna do some fishing, and I want deckhand Taylor and deckhand Grace to help the fisherman Sean over here identify what he catches, okay?
Oh.
So Sean, you're gonna work with me and we're gonna catch some local fish we have here off of the coast of Miami, okay?
Okay.
So come over here.
Let's see what we can find.
All right, let's throw out our line.
We're going fishing.
Oh, we got one.
You caught something
it's
big.
Oh, grab it, grab it. Oh, no. Miss,
wow.
Miss Penny got it.
Look at that.
That's
what
a big boy,
fish?
Huh?
It's
that
a flounder. Good job. I know. We're going to have to take this one home.
Ready?
I don't want to catch a
go
shark.
Ahead and drop the line.
I don't want to catch
Let's
a shark.
Let's go.
Oh,
there we go.
Oh,
my.
I have a fish. It's the dolphin fish.
Taylor, which fish is that?
The dolphin fish.
I know.
That one looks a little small, though. I think maybe we should throw that one back.
Should we throw it back?
Yeah.
All right.
Into the water again.
Back into the water.
Okay.
Taylor,
what
you're up.
What are you going to do, Miss Taylor?
Okay. I'll help you out, okay? You got it?
Well, there you go, there you go.
So close, oh my goodness. Which one is this?
Snapper.
A snapper.
Good job.
Yeah.
But guys, remember when we're fishing, we only want to keep fish that we're supposed to catch. So we only keep big fish and fish that there are plenty of in our waters, right?
Thank you so much for teaching us.
Thank you guys so much for coming out and being awesome young scientists.